Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for Reddit Up is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
This is Reddit Up, episode 5, recorded Wednesday, August 27th, 2014. Pizza Cats, Nolan Bushnell, and Samuel L. Jackson's cameo on Breaking Bad. Everybody, and welcome to Reddit Up. This is the show that covers all the fantastic stuff that happens on the little website you might know as Reddit. I'm Chad Johnson.
And I'm Sarah Lane. Hello, everybody. I was actually out last week. Thanks for keeping the show afloat without me.
Padre.
I bet it was hard.
It was. Padre's horrible. He's right back there. I couldn't stand the guy.
Sorry to do that to you.
I know.
I won't do it again.
Oh, gosh.
I missed it. I've really started enjoying these Reddit Up shows. Chad and I have been doing some beta shows before the official show launched. We're now on official episode 5. And if you're not familiar with the show or even Reddit, it is kind of the place where memes start and news breaks and a lot of the content that gets shared across the internet over the next hours, days, weeks, and months start on Reddit. So we thought we need a show about the originating place.
Yeah, it's great. And there's so much on Reddit. There's different subreddits where little communities are sprouted up. We can't possibly cover it all, but we hope that we cover the finer points.
It's an ongoing effort.
Oh, absolutely.
Week after week.
Absolutely.
To find the four corners of Reddit. But you're right. It's kind of infinite.
It is infinite. Like, did you know there's a Reddit for Petaluma? There's a Petaluma subreddit.
Okay.
For this tiny
town. That doesn't surprise me.
That has only a few thousand people living in it.
Well, but, you know, hey, I mean, there you go.
There you go.
Right. I mean, I think there's 30,000 people who live in Petaluma.
I think you overestimate how many people live in Petaluma.
Yeah. But in general, yes, you can find pretty much any subreddit, which we'll actually get to a little bit later in the show. But first, we like to start off this show, Reddit Up, with just some of the top stories that were voted up on the network.
Perfect.
Chad, you want to start?
Yeah, I'm going to take the first one. Elon Musk, wonderful guy, who's also known as Tony Stark, has a warning for us all that AIs could exterminate humanity.
Now, see, when I usually see a headline like this, I'm like, yeah, whatever. But Elon Musk kind of thinks about this on a deeper level, I think, than the average person, because he's sort of a superhero that's, you know,
right,
running Tesla and putting people in space.
I know. And his house, Jarvis, will eventually take over all of humanity. Still stuck on the Elon, Iron Man thing. What's funny is we've actually had great conversations about this on Twit. Elon Musk mentions two of the books that he's been reading, Superintelligence, Paths, Dangers, and Strategies by Nick Bostrom, and then also Our Final Invention, Artificial Intelligence and the End of the Human Era by James Brandt, who we actually had on Triangulation, James Barrett, actually, I think, not Brandt. So we've actually had this conversation here at Twit, and it's a fantastic article that's on Forbes where he mentions it. And this was submitted to r/futurology by Hepa Leroy.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
I love it.
So AI.
I mean, I don't want humanity to be destroyed, but I love the idea that it's at least being explored by people who...
Yeah.
Think deeply about this subject.
In when I read Neuromancer, they have AI, but it's tightly controlled in these almost computer vaults that they're not allowed to talk to other stuff, and they're super dangerous. I feel like that's the future we're moving towards, where AIs are going to be so scary that they could, in fact, duplicate themselves and make themselves smarter than humans, that it's really going to put all of humanity at risk, and these are going to be treated with more care than atomic weapons.
All right, Chad, you're frightening me, so I'm just going to go ahead and move along. This was actually submitted to the subreddit Data is Beautiful by a user, I Can Pun Anything. And it is
a little bit
more lighthearted. It's called What an Introvert Sounds Like, a study of 75,000 plus Facebook users. So here's the situation. It was a team of scientists working at the University of Pennsylvania that were using Facebook status updates to basically find common words and be able to glean emotion. You know, is somebody having a good day or a bad day? Is this a negative update versus a positive update? That sort of thing. So they put together what's called the World Wellbeing Project and actually asked people using Facebook to download an app called My Personality. So then the app asks people to take a personality test and just kind of get a better sense of who you are. So then matching up those personalities with all of these updates had some pretty interesting results. So an introvert, of course, is somebody who's a little bit more inward versus an extrovert, which is someone like me.
Who might talk to you on the bus or something.
Exactly. introverts, if we look at, there's actually, there's kind of a tag cloud here. Introverts on top. So anime plus XD looks like kind of the top signs.
You know, it's funny
that you're an introvert. Now, of course, down in extrovert land, party, can't wait, baby, chillin'. Night, ain't
girls,
boys.
Loving.
So, yeah, it's just kind of funny. Which is, you know, of course, these sorts of experiments can only scratch so much of the surface, but it is interesting.
Yeah. When you said XD, I was like, what in the world?
Yeah.
What that actually is they showed every of the words in this tag cloud as lowercase letters. So that's actually the emoticon that I like. Closed eyes, big up, happy face. And what's crazy is that if you look at the introvert, I just noticed this, is that it is filled with emoticons.
Now that's
But the extroverts, it is not. And so it seems that like introverts are emoting, but through emoticons on the internet.
Now see, I'm all about emoticons, but I like to think of myself as extroverted, so maybe I'm not.
I know. I think I play an extrovert. Like, right. I am an extrovert
on TV.
Mm-hmm. And then I want to go home and I don't want to talk to anyone. And
except
if I'm at parties. Except my cats. Yeah. No,
that's actually my life.
Like, if I'm at parties, like, I kind of need to get away after a while. I'm on too much. I need to go hide in the corner.
You could hide in the corner and get on to OkCupid.
Yeah, OkCupid. So this was submitted by Battered Cake to our funny. And this says, OkCupid has really low standards. And so the first frame, this is just an imager album. First frame is an email that you get if you're actually one of the hotter people on OkCupid. Mm-hmm, so if you've been on for a while and lots of people click on your profile, they have some sort of algorithm, they can tell that you're an attractive person and that, and then they give you this email that says, hey, we've determined that you're hot. We're also going to show you hotter people. You've been basically put into this A-list tier,
right.
on OkCupid.
I've gotten this
anyway,
email. Before.
So here's the user.
And it made me feel good about myself.
That had this email sent to them. They are a turtle. The user who got this email is a turtle.
A turtle named Joe, I guess.
I'm
a turtle.
I guess I'm a turtle.
Whatever.
Yeah.
So. Oh my gosh. OkCupid. Yeah, I mean, all that stuff is just phony baloney, right?
Right.
Want you to be like, I'm hot. I'm going to use this service.
Right.
With other hot
and
people.
If you haven't gotten that email and you've been using OkCupid, I'm sorry.
Pull
back that curtain.
I swear they give it to everybody.
Really?
They gave it to a turtle.
Okay.
So, I don't know, actually.
They did give
it to a turtle. If you haven't gotten the email, it's probably in your spam folder. You don't need it anyway.
Right.
They'll give it to anybody. Okay, let's move
on. Don't let OkCupid tell you who's hot, girl.
You're hot. Yeah.
Girl, you're shining star.
Yeah, okay. Girl. let's move on to basically the best thing that I saw on Reddit over the last week and really much longer than that. Pizza Hut Japan's new marketing campaign. Have you seen this on the internet? Yeah, it actually made the internet rounds, was very popular on Reddit as well. This was submitted by Voden Spla in a subreddit called Pizza, which is a great place to hang out if you're a pizza lover. So this is a marketing campaign for Pizza Hut. it's probably done by some outside thing. But the idea is that this Pizza Hut is now entirely run by cats.
By cats.
And I'm not exactly sure what the point is besides to say, well, this is kind of funny. But let's imagine if we would, if the Pizza Hut were really run by cats, what types of things would they do as employees? For example, you know, the phone's ringing.
Phone's ringing.
Somebody probably wants to order a pizza, you know?
Orders.
Yeah. Well, you got, you know, Mr. Pickles here. Just says, oh.
Oh, wait. Oh, I thought he was going to pick up.
No.
He's just sitting on the phone.
Yeah.
He's not answering the phone.
He says, you know what? I might take a nap.
And then they end with pizza tacos.
And there's like 50 of these. I mean, they really went all out.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
It seems like there was someone in a boardroom, and the pitch was people love cats.
Yeah.
I want to see another while I'm talking.
Could
by
we?
The way,
yeah,
if
we
can.
Just yeah, that would be cool.
And everyone said yes. People love cats. What it would be like if a Pizza Hut was run by cats, and then they just left it at that. They didn't let people know that they should animate them any further than what cats naturally are. And he's hiding behind a trash can looking at a... That's the end of it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I thought I liked this. Chad is having meltdown.
I saw one of these, and I thought it was fake.
Well, I mean...
Not until
Chad,
this
I'm not
show.
Sure that these cats really exist running a Pizza Hut in
no,
Japan.
No. I know that. But I saw the link on Reddit and I did not go to the site. I thought someone had made a fake Pizza Hut commercial. Oh my God, I'm just dying. I can't.
So, by the way, this is probably a good time to remind you that although this link is on Reddit, we have all these links in our show notes as well.
Yes.
At twit.tv/reddit.
So you can go enjoy all the videos.
Yeah. So if you're like, I need to watch more of these, you can just certainly do that after the show. All right.
I can't stand it.
Okay, let's move on to something that is certainly not funny, but it's still really, really awesome. And this is Reddit's third annual Global Reddit Service Day, which also is going to coincide with the Global Cardboard Challenge, both coming October 11th. That is a Saturday. So the situation here is that, as you know, Chad, Reddit mm-hmm. is really big on not just organizing community meetups, but also giving back to the community.
Yeah.
And it sounds like the service day last year was a little bit unorganized for a variety of reasons, because you're trying to organize volunteer events for large groups of people in different areas. So what they've done is actually
grouped up
with nonprofits that already exist.
That are local.
Animal shelters,
right.
For example,
cleanup
soup kitchen.
Crews,
yeah, I know. Of course, now it's an escape yeah. cleanup crews, all yeah. that stuff, all that good stuff. And so it's going to be a little bit more organized than it was before. And of course, it's happening in pretty much anywhere. I mean, anybody can participate right. in this sort of thing.
Right. And I kind of like that they are now. This is also the cardboard challenge, which is encouraging kids to build and create by donating and reusing cardboard that you would rather, you know, just, I guess, recycle, I don't know, or maybe throw away. But that's really fun. But I like that they're teaming up with local organizations to do the Reddit Service Day, because also after the day is over, people might go back and volunteer at that local organization, where if it was something they built for Reddit for a day, and then after that, they're done. I kind of like how Redditors would go to an organization that will still be there once it's over.
Yeah, just a little bit more information on the cardboard challenge. Last year, it was build your own arcade.
Oh.
Cardboard arcade. In fact, there is an embedded video, Josh, on that page if you can play it. But they educators, at least in the U.S., are raising money for various causes. They've partnered with an organization called National Head Start that introduces 30,000 preschool kids to a variety of technology. Something's going on in the background on this. Anyway, it seems
like Cardboard Day is happening just right over there, except with metal and doors that are very loud.
Yeah, exactly.
fun.
Yeah, it's just good stuff. This is the type of situation where Reddit really shines, and you say, you know, it's a funny, crazy place to hang out, but it's actually made up of a very big group of cool people who want to do cool stuff.
Oh, there you go. That's crazy.
Yeah.
And this is still in the same vein. You may remember on our very first episode, we covered the teacher exchange, which was part of the gift exchange. And instead of exchanging gifts, you would send something to a teacher in need. So this was posted to r/pics, and the title is "Thank You to the Redditors that did this for my wife's classroom." This is a really amazing community. She was crying with happiness when I got home, by Mr. Must Thomas, and it's a photo of his wife with all of the things that was donated to the teacher exchange. And in there's Harry Potter books, sticky notes, and something called Astro Brights, which I really want to find out what they are.
Is that like Light Brights?
I don't know. It might just be construction paper. Oh. Light Brights 2.0? Oh, we're getting the thumbs up.
Now, do you remember Light Brights?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, the big blackboard with an incandescent light.
And they tell you, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then your brother would come over and knock it, and then all your things would come out, and you'd start crying. Yeah.
I was an only child, so I always won.
Oh, you won the Light Brights? Yeah.
Yeah,
and they would give you pieces of paper. Do you remember that?
Yeah,
you could shove stuff into the paper. God, I love that.
What a weird toy.
I know.
But it was still like, Life Ride was awesome. Just the coolest thing. It kind of had that, I don't know, it was like a art installation of some kind, you know, for kids.
Absolutely. So moving on to the video break. So this comes from r/funny, submitted by The Rev. This photographer captured people's reactions the moment they were tased. So the video starts out and it's everyone getting ready to be tased, and then it starts off with this woman actually getting tased, and it's in slow motion, and they seem to all be naked for some random reason.
The nudity is upsetting to me.
Now they're not. You don't actually see anything.
I'm not upset because I imagine, you know, this is all slow motion, right? And being tased. I've seen somebody get tased before. We did on the Screensavers once, for anybody who remembers Tech TV days. And, you know, it's like really painful, and it's kind of a big deal. So you figure there's probably just a lot of like gravity situations.
Yeah.
As these people.
Yeah, and cellulite flapping.
Well,
sure. As your body switchily changes directions.
Some of us more than others, I'm sure. I just don't, I'm surprised so many people participated. And they don't even look that upset. They look like they're like, you hit me with a rubber band. Tasing.
Right. Apparently your significant other would be the person to actually administer the tase.
What? In what universe would that be something that would be okay?
You know, I don't, art.
For art.
The artistic universe.
Artsy naked people.
Yes.
It's a new thing.
Well, you don't want some random stranger to tase you while you're naked.
Hasn't come to the West Coast yet. We're just watching these videos saying, boy, are people crazy out there.
Yep. Yep.
Well, all right. Good video break, Chad.
Thanks.
Should we move on to our AMAs of the week?
I agree.
Yes, good. Ask Me Anything is what AMA stands for, of course, and it's a variety of celebrities and scientists and interesting people who answer questions that are submitted by pretty much anybody on Reddit and voted up. All right, so let's start off with Nolan Bushnell. Nolan Bushnell participated in an AMA. It was titled, "I am Nolan Bushnell, founder of Atari, Chuck E. Cheese, and most recently, Brain Rush, former boss and mentor to Steve Jobs, father of eight.
Eight?
Ask me anything."
I actually didn't know he's a father of eight.
That's a lot of kids.
Reliant asks, "What is your biggest lesson you learned at Atari or Chuck E. Cheese that you'll wish you had known before you had started?"
Which is, you know, it's...
That's a good question.
There's such different companies, you know. Nolan Bushnell, that's his username. He answers, "Don't sell to big Hollywood studios. Atari had an extraordinary corporate culture that was destroyed within 2 years of the sale. I think that Atari would still be important today if that sale hadn't occurred." Yikes. Just keeping it real there.
Yeah.
Truth telling.
Yeah. Hey, babe. I'm not gonna say that username on the air, but did Steve Jobs really stink that bad, or had he just regulated the work night shift?
Did he stink that bad that he had to be relegated
to the night work shift?
Yes,
or not?
Right. Nolan Bushnell answers, yeah, I knew that Jobs and Woz were fast friends, and Woz worked days at HP. If I put Jobs on the night shift, I'd get two Steves for the price of one. A very good business proposition.
Wow. That's pretty amazing.
So it's not because he was stinky. It's
right.
because he wanted them to
right.
maximize their Steve maximize. Efforts.
Absolutely.
Individually. So he kind of didn't answer the question, but whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. He didn't say if he stank or not.
No.
No. He's just maximizing profits, that Nolan Bushnell.
Exactly.
Lego Cactus asks, is it true that you had a beer tap in your office when you worked at Atari?
Nolan Bushnell answers, yes, and at Chuck E. Cheese. And at all of my companies.
I'd like, yeah, that's pretty cool.
Now, I would...
Why can't we have it
here? I was about to say, like, why can't we do something like that here? But yeah. we kind of do.
Yeah. We might not have the tap, but we have the flow.
Who needs tap when you have flow? All right, let's move on to Josh Brolin, actor, of course, also participated in an AMA. And the title of his was Josh Brolin, Goonies Never Say Die, AMA. Josh
that.
_ Brolin is his username.
This is Senses and Sadness asks, my girlfriend hasn't seen the Goonies. What's wrong with her?
Josh Brolin says, I'm concerned for her well-being. PM me an address and I'll send her a personalized DVD. Would she watch it then?
Wow. Who has a DVD player? No, I'm just kidding.
I have one in a closet.
I mean, you put your PS3 or whatever, yeah. probably play
yeah,
it.
Yeah, DVD, Josh.
When are you going to record a cover of Chameleonaire's Ridin'? They see me brolin', they hate me.
Okay, Sullivan's Name. Travels wanted Name. To know that question. Josh yep. Brolin answers, it's been a joke my kids' entire lives. Should we set it up now? His kids must be really young.
Maybe.
Because that song is, like, not that old.
They see me rolling, they hate, that's way old.
It's not that old.
What?
Chameleonaire hasn't been around that long.
Can we get fact check on this? I'm pretty positive it's at least, like, 15 years old.
No.
Okay. I will take your word for it.
Okay.
Vitalik Korean asks, when will you start hosting the web series Trollin' with Josh Brolin, in which you scour internet articles and post outrageous comments and in message boards? And Josh Brolin says...
Actually, you're right. It's really old.
How old is it?
1996.
Oh,
damn!
Yes, almost 20 years in 2 years.
That's right. Good mathematics,
Woo!
Chad.
On the fly.
18,
I'm
in
fact.
Horrible
at math.
Okay,
on
so
air.
That makes way more sense that Josh Brolin's like, this has just been a joke my kids' entire lives.
Yeah.
I was like, that sounds like 4 years ago. So they're like, were they really thinking
I'm
that?
I'm sorry
they
to
were
shatter
year
your
old?
Dreams.
It's okay. No, it's good. Okay, back on track.
So the question is, you should start an internet series called Trollin' with Josh Brolin. When are you going to start that up?
Josh Brolin says, I love that idea right now. Better than my old buddy's idea of brawling with Brolin.
I'd love to see that, too.
I don't know. I don't like any of these ideas.
So the
but, you know, he's what a good sport.
Yeah, good sport. He seemed like a good sport all around.
Yeah.
Yeah, normally those guys are. So what are the AMAs coming up?
AMAs coming up, starting with Eli Manning, quarterback for the New York Giants. He will be participating in AMA on August 29th. That's in 2 days. If you're watching the show live on Wednesdays when we record it, which is usually at about 5 p.m. Pacific time, right after Tech News Tonight. Otherwise, hopefully you can catch it in time. Michael Cera and Kieran Culkin. Kieran Culkin is Macaulay Culkin's younger brother.
Oh, wow.
They are both part of a Broadway show, This Is Our Youth, and they will be participating in AMA on September 2nd. And then steampunk author Cherie Priest will be participating in an AMA on September 3rd. So you've got some fun stuff coming up. Hopefully one of those piques your interest. You've got some good questions to ask, and it will be upvoted, and it will be answered by your hero.
Perfect. Coming up, the next, this is like my favorite section of the whole show, the awe of the week. Roll it. Oh, my God. That duck has absurd feet.
Oh, look at Buddy. Somebody has a hurdy-hurd.
Animals with broken limbs are always cute.
That one.
Oh, God. We caught him.
That one I love. That is a little graphic, actually. Hi, I'm a fox.
Oh, my gosh.
Hi, I'm on a carpet.
Oh, man.
Distracted by those nails.
You like them or not like them?
Not like them.
No, mm-mm. That was not aw.
Babies aww. Make everything worse.
Everything worse? Worse?
Yeah. It was wow, a perfectly good picture, and then you got duds. A baby, and it's just like...
Whoop. You're like, that dog is so cute, that yeah. baby can...
I'm just kidding. I'm not totally dead inside.
So, moving on to the subreddit of the week. This one is called, Shut Up and Take My Money! And you can imagine what it is filled with. Awesome products that you absolutely need or want to buy. Just as a great example, one of the most upvoted at number three is Zombie Apocalypse Mountain Bike / Motorcycle. This thing is super intense that it is not only a motorcycle, so if you run out, or so you can, you know, zip away from those zombies. It also has a bike pedal, so if you run out of gas, you can bike along. And then, you know, for added measure, a crossbow added to the back. Looks like you got an axe, some sort of hatchet. This thing, oh my gosh.
What are you doing with all of these weapons?
It's fighting zombies.
Okay.
It was called a zombie apocalypse bike.
Yeah, well, but.
And motorcycle.
But I understand that, but in the absence of zombies, why would you need it?
Because
you like to live in a fantasy world.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's fine.
Basically.
I love it.
Some others.
Shut up and take my money. That's. I mean, I live like.
Okay. So you.
Like
okay.
This.
The zombies might be fake, but you know what's real?
What?
Parties.
Yes.
Check out this can in a stein that you add any can to, and it makes it a beer stein. How do you like that?
I like it very much.
Okay, okay.
I like it very much. I actually know somebody who collects those.
What?
Like from Germany.
Steins, actual steins.
Yeah,
I was like,
cans.
He collects beers in a stein? Because I thought that was the first time I saw it.
No. The actual steins. I think okay. he would get a kick out of that. And funny that you knew it was a man, because I specifically did not say gender.
Oh.
You're just
I thought you said I had a... Oh, you said I had a friend.
Yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
It seems like a guy thing to collect steins.
I guess it kind of is.
Here's
yeah.
here's
he
one
is
more.
A guy. He's a guy.
Is a wooden watch. So this could be for any gender. Isn't that neat? It's just
very
really
I love it. I don't understand
cool.
how you tell the time, but you could probably figure it out.
I think you
out.
Can only tell the hour.
Oh, so wait, I get wait, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's 6:50, I bet.
Oh.
That's cool. I want that.
6:50, yeah. So
cool.
It's white, it goes up white to where the hour is, and then there'll be a red dot whatever minute.
Or it's 10:30.
Yeah, either. Very neat.
Love
yes,
it.
I like
want
it a lot.
Want it.
Want
take
it.
My money.
Take
just
my,
take my money.
Shut up and take my money.
Okay.
And yeah, so that's, and you know, there's even a website also dedicated, but I like the Reddit because it gets churned through a lot faster.
All right, let's move on to the Ask Reddit of the Week. This is a question that is posed, and anybody on Reddit can participate in the answers. And they're fun. They're fun. It's like they're like,
fun.
I feel like, because Chad and I will also participate just as part of the show, why not? And it's like a fun, almost a brain exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Because
mm-hmm.
you sort of have to think of something that's
and you have to
cool
try to be clever.
And, yeah, exactly. Yeah. So that's sort of the point of it. Okay, here's the question of the week. This was submitted by DBIZL. What items for under $10, US dollars, would amaze people from 100 years ago? So it's 2014. We're talking 1914. For under $10. Now, a lot of people said things like calculator, obviously, that's, you know, digital watches, not around in 1914. But there are some more unique suggestions as well.
Yeah, Daylin, whose grandmother was 100 when she passed away.
Good genes.
Yeah, says she would have said scotch tape.
Oh.
The idea that she didn't have to tie something with actually string, that scotch tape was just this fascination. With her grandmother.
Toaster Poodle said candy, or any food for that matter, with artificial colors and flavors. For example, you know, it's 1914 and you're like, hey, have some blue raspberry candy. And they're like, well, there's no such way to
just show understand. Them that scene from Hook when they eat the feast. Peter Pan?
Yeah.
You remember that?
I don't think I saw that.
Oh, lame bangarang.
The Southern
Nerd says a photograph of Earth.
Ooh.
An actual photograph of Earth.
Yeah.
That would be very shocking.
Very confusing. Yeah. Very confusing.
Yeah.
Which, and that's, see, that's smart, because if you're thinking for under $10, you're like, well, spaceship, that's not, but a photograph. There you go.
Yeah, that's a postcard of Earth.
That's a very good one. Roan Ark said, hand them a large movie popcorn and tell them it costs $9.99. That'll freak them out.
Absolutely.
Good
How much would a popcorn cost back then, do you think? A cent? Half nickel? I don't know.
I don't know. I think
a half nickel.
I think my parents used to, you like, do a double feature for like a nickel.
Yeah.
On a Saturday.
Yeah.
I mean, and that was
I remember being
in the
blown
50s.
Away by the concept of a hay penny when I was a child.
I don't know what that is.
A hay penny was supposed is a half penny.
There's a half penny.
Yes. You were having the exact yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Really?
It was a
never heard of it.
Hay penny. No, it's funny, there's an actual it's an HA apostrophe
penny.
Not an actual hay penny, because there's pennies that actually have hay on them, but half penny, a pre-decimal coin.
Oh my goodness.
Now, I don't think this was ever in America,
okay.
But I remember reading books where they'd say, give a poor beggar a hay penny.
Uh-huh.
And
right? Okay.
I was just like, well, anything would ever cost less
but you know,
than a penny.
Those Brits, they've, you know, Poppins and Quid.
Yeah.
All it, Stones.
I thought you were talking about Mary Poppins. Mary
Poppins. I was. Feed the birds,
okay,
Poppins
good.
A bag.
Good.
Anyway, okay, let's move on.
So my answer would be an LED flashlight.
Ooh.
Because how insane. So I had to look up when the light bulb was invented.
Yeah.
It was 1890.
Yeah.
But the idea that you would have a flashlight that would not burn out for 10,000 hours and that emitted no heat, basically no heat. Some LEDs actually emit a lot of heat, but that could also run for so long and then be put on, most LED flashlights can be put underwater. Like, mm-hmm. I couldn't imagine how someone, and how bright and how pure that light would seem compared to a lot of the light that was available, like the early incandescent bulbs or candlelight or wick burning lamps or something like that.
Blowing their minds back in 1914 with the LED flashlight. Okay, so for mine, I was like, what's under $10? Nothing's under $10 anymore, except things at drugstores, right? Drugstores are full of items for under $10. So two of them that I thought were really good were 5-Hour Energy.
that would
under
$10.
And, you know, right, but it's like, you know, the human body itself hasn't changed that much, right? I mean, maybe we've evolved slightly, but I don't really think so. So it's like the concept of just take this,
right,
and you'll have so much more energy, you know, than you think, and you don't even have to chew on a cocoa leaf or anything. And then the second one is self-tanner.
They would think you are insane.
Like, what?
Why on earth would you want to look more tan?
Well, and I think I think it's cultural and it's also scientific, right? Because culturally, at least in some places, if you're out working on the farm all day,
right,
you know, and you're getting tanner, that's maybe saying something about your wealth level, right?
Yeah,
rather than staying inside
are,
and, be, you know,
the, yeah, the more
and,
you,
you
could,
know,
yeah.
fanning yourself and drinking your mint julep or whatever.
Right.
Did they have those in 1914? I'm not sure.
I'm sure.
But also,
at least up till 19,
the technology of, you know, spray this L'Oreal Sublime Bronzer on, and you'll just get darker in 6 hours or less.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. I remember, this is even older than 1914, but I remember watching some show, and this woman goes into a general store, and she picks up a jar, and it had threads on it, where you could screw and unscrew the jar. And there was this moment in the movie or whatever, she just went, so amazing. The inventions are so amazing. And like the teacher had to pause the film to be like, up until that point, like everyone had to seal their jars like in a different, like with like clamps or whatever.
Wow.
And the idea of a threaded jar like hadn't existed. It's just like, how is, you know, we've come so far.
I think
far.
About that all the time.
All the time.
This is actually something I can legitimately say I think about all the
all
time.
All the time.
All
so
the time.
Let's
okay.
move on to Today I Learned. So today I learned that Weezer's first gig was opening for Keanu Reeves' band Dogstar.
Wow. I remember Dogstar. Sort of.
Also, how do you open for Keanu? If that's their first gig and they open for for Keanu Reeves?
Everybody's got to start somewhere. You know, Dog Star got a lot of attention because Keanu Reeves was, he was a big star.
Yeah.
Bill and Ted, then he did, whatever other movies he did.
Yeah, and then he did that one.
He did like a million movies. The Matrix.
He did The Matrix.
I think Dog Star sort of preceded that era. But clearly, I don't know my years. We've established
that.
What
was it? Johnny Mnemonic.
That too. Yeah, he kind of did a lot of sci-fi stuff for a while.
Yeah.
But yeah, he was also a rock star. He was the Jared Leto of his time. All right, today I learned that your body, this is submitted by The Derv, your body is constantly replacing old cells with new ones at the rate of millions per second. So, by the time you finish reading this sentence, 50 million of your cells will have died and been replaced by others. This was kind of gross to me.
No way.
50 million. There are a lot of cells in these.
I knew that enough lose enough skin cells to build a 7-year-old child or something like that throughout your life. Something like that.
Worthy of Josh Brolin.
We can build another child. Okay, the next one is submitted by DavyK95. Today, I learned that Samuel L. Jackson wanted a cameo appearance on Breaking Bad, in which he would walk onto the set of the Los Palos Hermanos. Dressed as Nick Fury, completely unannounced, as if he were a customer buying chicken from the restaurant.
The best part of it is that didn't happen, because I watched the whole series, so I wonder, it's like, who was like, you know,
no.
What? No, that's really distracting and
Sorry,
kind of
Samuel,
a little off course.
Yeah.
We sort of have this plot line.
It's a funny pitch, but we'll think about
right,
it.
Right, yeah, it's this is, you're not, no.
And then they turn to the other, God, Samuel.
Yeah, it just,
always,
he's just trying to insert himself into all the really interesting, shows on ABC, or on ABC,
On the television.
On the, what was it? What was the channel?
AMC.
Not ABC. I don't know my channels anymore. Everything's all on Hulu. Okay, TIL. This is a good one. Flavor Flav. Flavor Flav, of course, of Public Enemy. TIL, Flavor Flav is a musical prodigy, says Yertle the Turtle. By the time he started performing with Public Enemy, he was proficient in 15 different instruments, from drums to the oboe.
That's so crazy.
I'll take your word for it, because I know he... I don't know anything about that.
The Celebrity House...
right.
It's a reality TV show.
Yeah.
And he played the drums.
The Surreal Life.
Sure.
That's what it was called.
The Surreal Life. He played the drums, and he was really bad at it.
But he might, have done some damage.
I saw him do one instrument once in my life, and I am convinced that he is bad at all instruments.
Good at wearing clocks. Good at saying, boy.
Yes.
Flavor Flav. I don't know.
Now, he probably is. I mean, if that's his passion, that's his passion.
15 different instruments. At least at some point.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Very good. Very very good trivia.
Wait,
thank you.
Okay, I would want to figure out what these different instruments would be, because if it's bass guitar, 6-string guitar, 12-string guitar, lute, there's a lot of things that could be played basically the same.
Chad, don't take this away from us.
Okay.
This is really, really interesting.
Okay.
TIL.
I'm just trying to dig down and learn a little more. You need to do your research, Mr. Yurl the Turtle.
That's why it's TIL.
Okay.
You just have to take it at
he
face value.
He probably gave us lots here. We could probably go
show
back.
Us the video.
Yeah, or it didn't happen.
Right, yeah.
This is an article from The Guardian. So we all know The Guardian lies all the time.
What are you talking
about? This was the evidence.
The originating article.
Yeah, because you'll put a TIL and the subject will be what you learned, and then it'll show. So how many instruments was it? 15? 15 minutes? 15 instruments. He can play 15 instruments.
That's what it said.
I can't play lotto.
That's what it said. All right, Chad, let's move on.
Chad
did not want to take that one lying down.
No, I was not. that comes about to the end of our show. If you'd like to help submit some stories, suggestions, or feedback to us, you can hit us up at our subreddit at reddit.com/r/redditup. That's our very own place. And we also post the show notes from the previous episode. So you can see RedditUP episode 4 show notes are up there, submitted by our technical director, the Mac and Josh. And there you can comment and discuss, and maybe there's something that you really want to see us do or talk about. You could post those stories in there as well.
Exactly. And I like all our shows on Twit, twit.tv/reddit, or twit.tv/RU. Both of them will work. That is the place to subscribe to the show if you're enjoying it. Of course, we'll post the links on our subreddit page, but if you can subscribe to the show, then you can watch or listen whenever your little heart desires. But we love it when you join us live. A reminder that we are live right after TN2 on Wednesdays at about 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern time. Hopefully that's a good time for all of you. Again, if not, subscribe to the show and watch or listen, and it's all up to you. On demand.
Perfect.
Yeah, good times. All right, Chad. So should we do this whole thing same time next week?
Next week?
Week?
I'll be here.
I'll be here.
I hope you're here.
We hope you're here. Yeah. Okay.
Bye.
Great outro. All right. We really kept it together at the end.